right now, if you take a look at any over-the-counter sunscreens, you have sort of two options. You have chemical-based sunscreens. You also have what's called physical-based sunscreens, and those are usually titanium dioxide-based or zinc oxide-based.
Everyone should wear sunscreen every day, not just during the summer, but when you have to choose what sunscreens to use, I would recommend choosing those that have physical UV filters. What has been shown in recent data is that these chemical UV filters were accumulating throughout our bloodstream and circulating throughout our body.
As far as what's going on to the marine ecosystem, the ocean water washes off the sunscreen from your skin, and then that sort of penetrates through the water. There's some 8,000 tons of sunscreen that's kind of all over the ocean right now. Can we figure out a way to develop new types of sunscreens that are safe for the environment, that are safe for the ocean?
We at the Biomaterials Design Group study a class of organisms known as cephalopods,
and that includes octopus and cuttlefish and squid. The reason why we started studying these animal systems is because they change color really fast.
We were able to see that these pigments, in addition to their wide range of color, are able to absorb UV radiation.
We're thinking it's a quite promising pathway to start looking at new sort of alternative, safer UV filters.